Global Alliance Against Traffic in Women was founded in 1994 by a group of women activists. The founders, through their activism, had heard many stories of trafficked women and sex workers, women who were experiencing stigma, lack of protection, poor working conditions, and broken promises from corrupt officials. The Gaatw founders wanted to challenge stereotypes of trafficked women only as victims. They wanted to rethink issues of migration and trafficking, understand the perspective of trafficked and migrating women, take a stand politically and question policies and services for trafficked and migrating women. Two clear tasks were identified at the launch of the Alliance. One, to work towards a clear and unambiguous understanding of trafficking that would inform legislation as well as social action. And two, to ensure that the human rights of trafficked women are protected by law. Since 1994, we have published reports on trafficking and the rights of migrants and women. In 2012, launched the Anti-Trafficking Review, the world's first peer-reviewed journal on the subject. Helped to expand the limited definition of trafficking to the broader concept adopted in the United Nations Trafficking Protocol. Run training for trafficking survivors and activists on topics such as health, advocacy, and access to justice. Delivered participatory research projects involving the voices of trafficking survivors and practitioners, and advocated for trafficking survivors and migrating women's rights through UN mechanisms and statements. Gaatw member organisations about their highlights from the last 3 years, and here are some of their replies. Amumra, Argentina, helped pass a new migration law that acknowledges human rights. Atki, Hong Kong and Indonesia, campaigned for the ratification of the United Nations Convention on Migrant Workers' Rights in Indonesia. CHS Alternativo Peru created and implemented a police system to register and report trafficking statistics. Fair Work Netherlands raised awareness of trafficking for labour exploitation outside of the sex sector. Institute for Social Development India formed a network of organisations working on violence against women, including trafficking survivors. Opengate Macedonia established the first shelter for trafficked persons in the country. HRDF Turkey was the first non-governmental organisation to conduct training for law enforcement and judiciary personnel. Award Thailand organised a self-reliance women's group at grassroots level.
Gaatw is several years ahead of the curve in terms of anti-trafficking thinking, anti-trafficking work, advocacy at the global level. And I think that now that Gaatw is 20, we can firmly establish the concrete contributions they have made to shaping the anti-trafficking discourse globally.
I really hope that the Alliance will be there for another 20 years, and I wish all the members and all the board and international staff and associates, all the best.
Ahora desde la junta directiva en representación de la red Latinoamérica y Caribe, creo que estamos en posibilidad de continuar con un trabajo regional y hacer alianzas con las otras regiones y continuar en los próximos 20 años, ojalá, avanzando y luchando por los derechos humanos de los migrantes y sobre todo de las personas en situación de trata.
Yet to our great disappointment,
the protection and promotion on the lives of trafficked women, children, or men. It's not yet clear on the agenda, and there are many areas that we can improve. So I think that Gaatw has a mission to continue in order to promote this.